microbiology has grown by leaps and bounds in last decade, and no second day is similar. In every day it is a new challenge, it's a new day every day, and I think past 1.5 year has been even different, more different. So we've gone a long way from antimicrobial resistance, infection control, and even microbiology diagnostic themselves in last whole decade, but last 1.5 year has pushed everything far, far more. So I think that's what keeps on going all the time. So I think when I was a student, which was decades ago, we used to talk only on biomedical waste disposal, and we have come far, far ahead from there to hand hygiene, to infection control, to infection prevention. So it has been a very, very long journey, and in fact, again, back to the same last 1.5 year, the media itself has created a long lasting effect on community also. It's not only now hospital or microbiologist talking. The intensivists have started talking in, the surgeons have got their own chip in. So I think it has evolved a lot from last 2 decades with respect to 1.5 year, far, far better, far better. So you now hear everybody talking about it. And accreditation has helped. So management has got concerned. So I think that has been an important issue as far as infection control is concerned. So hospital-associated infection prevention has been a very important work. Not only for microbiologists, but all the doctors or the nursing department, for everybody, because the moment you have less infection, your hospital is considered better in all the perspective. Probably your revenues also go up, and morally you feel much, much better about it. So what do I advise my peers is, most of us adopt to the CDC guidelines. Sometimes we do look at European guidelines, but our circumstances have not been exactly same, and we always modify. So my advice would be modify, confidently modify, and do the best that you require to do in your setting. And that is the most challenging and most fruitful, both the way. So my advice is read a lot and adapt a lot for your own self. I think all of us working in private or government setup needs always a lot of help. As the working has changed, as the consideration about quality or infection control has changed, that has had its own role of corporate like you, which has really pushed things for better. So what do I require from corporate setup will always be some more reading material, some help in conducting more lectures, training inside my own hospital also, because many a times the external help is very, very useful. So also the some of the organization also helping audit. So these are the smaller things that I would require in my own setup. Some of the corporates also help in doing accreditation itself. So that also helps because the quality standards come in place. And last but not least would be the media support, because that overall helps, you know, when everybody in general is aware, which includes the community or management or the surgeon or the lab, it helps. So the general awareness or media awareness is extremely crucial, especially in the days when we live in a lot of virtual times. So I think that is what I would request for corporates to help with. I think as far as infection prevention is concerned, if we read the website at various places, people say that it is everybody's business or everybody should chip in. And in India, we have still not reached there. We are on the way, we've grown quite a bit, but we are still not there. So my request would be to all the other departments apart from microbiology and nursing, like surgeon or intensivist, to consider that as part of their own work, which right now we have a huge scope to grow. So I think that everyone's business is still has not been everyone's in India, and I think that is where we need to make progress.